Today, we'll prepare three dishes that all have a vegetable as their star ingredient. We'll make a beet yogurt, roasted tahini carrots, and zucchini fritters. These are all very straightforward recipes, so let's begin.
For our first recipe, we'll be using raw beets, olive oil, garlic, lemon, plant-based yogurt, and salt. First, preheat the oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. Then, thoroughly wash and scrub the beets. Pat dry and place them on a baking tray lined with parchment paper or a silicone baking sheet. Drizzle some olive oil, then place it in the oven. Personally, I'm pretty generous with the olive oil because I love the taste of it. These should be ready in about 45 minutes to an hour. This depends on the size of the beets and on your oven. You can simply check if they're soft enough with a fork. When the beets are done, wait for at least 15 minutes so that they're cool enough to roughly peel. Then, using the side with the largest blades, grate the beets. In a separate bowl, add the minced garlic and squeeze the lemon directly on top of it. Set aside for a few minutes. Mix everything thoroughly. Then garnish with nigella and sesame seeds, dried mint, and parsley to serve. If you don't have access to plant-based yogurt, check out this link where I show you how you can make your own yogurt with starter culture. Our next dish could not be simpler. We're only using carrots, olive oil, tahini, lemon juice, pumpkin seeds, and pomegranate arils. Drizzle with olive oil, then place them in the oven. They need about 20 to 30 minutes at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. If you're cooking this on the same day that you're cooking the beets, just place them in the oven a little bit later. While the carrots are baking, we'll make our simple tahini sauce. Squeeze the lemon into tahini, add water, and mix. To bring our carrots to the next level, let's toast some pumpkin seeds. When the carrots are done baking, give them a few minutes to cool down. Then drizzle the tahini sauce and sprinkle with the pumpkin seeds and pomegranate arils. Ready to be served. And finally, the zucchini fritters, or as we call it in Turkey, mücveh. First, let's make the flax eggs by adding warm water to ground flax seeds, then setting it aside for a few minutes. It's ready when you see this thick consistency. For our recipe, we're using zucchini, potato starch, tapioca starch, flax eggs, baking soda, chickpea flour, parsley, spring onions, garlic, lemon, salt, and oil. Start by peeling and grating the zucchinis. The next step is to drain out all of its water. I'm using cheesecloth for this, but my grandmother does it with her bare hands, so that also works. Into the drained grated zucchini, add in chopped parsley, scallions, minced garlic, salt, lemon juice, and flax eggs. Then set aside for a few minutes. Since we added salt, this will ensure further water release through osmosis. Meanwhile, combine the chickpea flour, potato starch, tapioca starch, and baking soda. When the zucchini mix has released more water, add in this combination and mix it in to make the batter. For the final step of making our fritters, add oil into a pan and bring it to medium to high heat. I prefer using fresh olive oil for frying. This minimizes the taste of aldehydes, but you can use any frying oil that you like. fry each side for a few minutes until they turn golden brown. This dish needs to be served immediately once fried, but you can make the batter a day ahead. Serve with plant-based yogurt and more parsley. For a full meal, you can serve these dishes together or with a grain on the side, like pita, farro, or bulgur pilaf.
I hope that these recipes gave you an idea on how you can incorporate more vegetables into your diet as well. If they did, please let me know down in the comments which one you'd like to start out with first. Alright, thank you so much for watching, and until we meet again in the next video, be well.